Good morning, and welcome to Northwest Missouri State University's Bearcat Arena and the commencement exercises for spring 2014. I'm Amanda Pettifish-Schrag, Associate Professor of Theater in the Department of Fine and Performing Arts. The candidates for graduation will enter the arena soon, but I first would like to introduce our musicians. You have been listening to the Bell Tower Brass Ensemble under the direction of Maestro John Bell. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bell Tower Brass Ensemble. Please allow me to make a couple of announcements before the ceremony begins. Out of respect for our graduates, we ask that you please silence all cell phones. For the candidates to safely proceed to and exit from the stage, we ask that you not take photographs in the area directly in front of the stage. We thank you in advance for your cooperation. Please stand for the presentation of flags. Members of the Northwest ROTC present today's honor guard. International students who represent their classmates carry the flags of their countries. They are led by International Affairs Coordinator Ms. Ashley Hengler. Please remain standing for the entrance of the platform party. The platform party is led by Grand Marshal Dr. Phil Labor, Professor of Art in the Department of Fine and Performing Arts. The Northwest banner is being carried by the Student Senate President, Cody Ewing. Northwest Missouri State University proudly presents the candidates for degrees from the Melvin D. and Valerie G. Booth College for Business and Professional Studies. College includes the following academic departments: Business, Agricultural Sciences, Communication, and Mass Media. Graduates are escorted by Honor Banner Carrier, Mr. Jaron Robinson. Thank you. please welcome the candidates for degrees from the Graduate School. Northwest confers the following graduate degrees: Master of Science, Master of Arts, Master of Business Administration, Master of Science in Education, and Specialist in Education. Graduates are escorted by Graduate School Marshal Dr. Shiloh Lim, Associate Professor of Management in the Department of Business, and by Honor Banner Carrier Ellie Backus. Please welcome the faculty of Northwest Missouri State University. Assisting our faculty is Dr. Carla Edwards, Professor of Psychology in the Department of Behavioral Sciences.
Thank you.
Please remain standing, face the flag on the stage, and join in singing our national anthem led by graduate student Nathaniel Orr.
Oh, say can you see, by the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. Now, please welcome the president of Northwest Missouri State University, Dr. John Jasinski.
Good morning, Bearcats. Oh, wait, I told the graduates over in the rec center we're going to have a somber, okay, I'm very excited to be here, ceremony. No way, it's a beautiful day. Every day is a great day to be a Bearcat, but especially today, welcome to the Spring 2014 commencement ceremonies at Northwest Missouri State University. I know our degree candidates will fondly remember this day, the day that your perseverance pays off, your success at achieving something so few actually accomplish. You know, ladies and gentlemen, only about one-third of Americans go through this kind of ceremony and graduate from college. So we're very proud of each and every one of you today. As I talk to you, as I did the rounds there in the rec center, we want you to have a great day today. And it's not just today, but it's every day. And think about your time at Northwest Missouri State, undergraduate, graduate students, and all around that that impacted your lives. I do offer Bearcat greetings to our graduates, family, and friends, each and every one of you here. Thank you for attending and being supportive of your sons and daughters. Also, I welcome our faculty, our staff, our platform guests, and especially our commencement speaker, Missouri Senator Brad Lager. Brad, thank you for being here, and thanks to your family as well. And I do welcome our online viewers. Northwest students, you've learned to lead with integrity, treat others with respect, have sound reasoning, and provide facts as you address and solve issues of all types. Northwest's role is pretty easy. Provide you with a high-quality education and engage vigorously. Engage vigorously in your success. Your role is to continue to engage in your learning environment. Be lifelong learners, take advantage of your opportunities, and prepare to better the communities in which you live, work, and play. And another one of your roles is to connect. We talk about Bearcats Connect. And think about that phrase for a moment. Think about how you've connected up with faculty and staff in your years here at Northwest Missouri State. How you've connected up with new friends. How our alumni connect with you. How the work world connects with you. Bearcats do indeed connect. And that's an important role that we want you to play as you walk out of Northwest Missouri State University. Let me just share a couple of facts with you in terms of our graduating class. We have about 668 candidates in the spring class of 2014. You range in age from about 20 to 60. Top undergraduate major in the spring class of 2014 is business management. Top graduate degree is applied computer science. 535 of you are undergraduate degree candidates, 121 graduate degree candidates, and 8 specialists in education degree candidates. We have candidates from Missouri, Iowa, Nebraska, international students from 8 different countries, including Australia, Canada, India, Ireland, Japan, Nepal, People's Republic of China, and Taiwan. No matter the road you traveled to get here to Northwest Missouri State University, I encourage you to celebrate the past, but especially be future-focused. It'll take perseverance, collaboration, citizenship, and hard work, but those are all the things that we practice here at Northwest Missouri State University. And as you sit here and think and kind of reflect back about your time at Northwest, I think some of those memories come out in so many different ways, and we put together a short video for you to share some reflections. So just take a seat back here and watch this video, please. How's that for a video? Huh? That's why social media is so important. We want to make sure you guys are on Twitter right now. It's posted online. It's a great video. Please stay with us for the ceremony. Then after the ceremony, you can check that out. With all seriousness, the reflections that are our part of that video are unbelievable. Darren Whitley from our University Relations Office and his team put together several reflections, and really the theme was pretty critical. That was of family, of a time of celebration, a very special place at Northwest Missouri State University. Ladies and gentlemen, before I call Senator Lager to the podium, please allow me to recognize a few people. I would be remiss to not call out Dinah Stevens. Dinah, I've got to figure out where you're at here in the crowd. Right here. Dinah is a Northwest employee who sits among you this morning as a fellow graduate. We wish you congratulations, Dinah, on your dedication to Northwest and your perseverance to reach your personal goals. So thank you very much, Dinah, and congratulations to you. Graduates, we call this ceremony a commencement because we celebrate not only a chapter in your life that will culminate today, but it's also a beginning today to what you will accomplish in the years ahead. Please help me recognize your families and loved ones who have helped you to get to this point in this culminating experience. So to your family and friends, thank you very much for your support. And graduates, how about our faculty and staff? You know, we talk about people making a difference in every organization, and in fact, people do make a difference. At Northwest Missouri State University, I know each and every one of you have had close relationships with a variety of faculty and staff. And as I travel the country and talk to other presidents and talk to state representatives and legislators and so on, I have to tell you that I always put our faculty and staff at the very top because they truly make a difference. So please help me thank the faculty and staff here. And of course, behind me, members of our Board of Regents, the Northwest Leadership Team, the Dean's Council, Faculty and Student Senate Presidents, faculty members, and our Registrar, as well as our State Representative Mike Thompson. Mike is a Northwest alumnus, and we all know that he's a champion of education. So please help me thank our platform party here. And now I'm pleased to introduce to you Senator Brad Lager. He'll be sharing today's commencement address with you. Senator Lager was born right here in Maryville. He's a lifelong resident of Northwest Missouri. He graduated from Northeast Nottoway High School and is a proud, very proud alumnus of Northwest Missouri State University, having earned his Bachelor of Science degree in Computer Management Systems at the university in 1997. Senator Lager began his career in public service in 2001 when he was elected to the Maryville City Council, then the youngest member to serve on the governing body. From 2002 to 2006, he served as the 4th District Representative in the Missouri House of Representatives. In 2006, Senator Lager was elected to represent the 12th Senatorial District, in which he worked tirelessly to ensure Missouri's state government is reasonable, fiscally responsible, and accountable to the people it serves. In 2007, Senator Lager secured the largest capital investment ever made to Northwest by the state of Missouri, the $24.4 million investment funded Northwest's Center for Innovation and Entrepreneurship. In addition to serving as the chair of numerous committees, Senator Lager has been honored with the Missouri Chamber of Commerce and Industry Man's Man in the Arena Award, the Regional Chamber and Growth Association's Lewis and Clark Statesman Award, and the Missouri Community College Association's Distinguished Legislator Award, among others. Please help me give a warm, very warm Bearcat welcome to Senator Brad Lager.
Well, good morning. President Jasinski, members of the Board of Regents, members of the faculty, staff, parents, and most importantly, the 2014 graduates of Northwest Missouri State. You know, it is truly an honor to be here today and a privilege to stand before you. As a proud 1997 graduate of Northwest, I can honestly tell you that my experiences here have without a doubt helped to shape who I am. Now, before I go any further, I do want to take a moment and recognize another person on the platform. He is a man that spent the last 8 years representing Northwest in this region. He's a man of integrity, a man of character, a true public servant. He is about to complete his final year in the House, and when he does, his departure will leave a void that will be hard to fill. I truly know no better advocate for Northwest Missouri State than Representative Mike Thompson. Please join me in thanking Mike for his years of service. I never imagined that I would end up in the public sector. Never dreamed I would have the opportunity and the honor of representing my home, my family, my community, and really this great institution in our capital. I'm proud to call myself a Bearcat. I'm thankful for the opportunities and the life lessons that I gained during my time here. But most importantly, I am proud of this institution. You know, there are times in life when we take a moment to joyfully recognize the great accomplishments of those people that are around us. Today is one of those days. To the graduating class, I say congratulations. To the family, friends, faculty, staff, and all the folks seated in this auditorium who supported these graduates through the years, I say thank you. The achievements of these graduates would not have been possible without the selfless support and constant encouragement of all of you. You've been instrumental in their success, and I am committed and I am grateful that you are committed to their futures. Now, to the 2014 graduates. A few months ago, I was sitting in my Capitol office, making some notes and an outline of kind of what I wanted to share today, and Mike came by. And as Mike and I sat in the Capitol, thinking big thoughts like elected officials do, I shared with Mike how excited I was to be giving this address. You know, it's not often that you have the opportunity to be the commencement speaker that holds such a special place in your heart. You know, I grew up here, graduated from here. Much of who I am today is because of my time here. And you know, my mom, myself, my brother, my sister, my wife, her brother, her sister, you get it, all attended Northwest. To say the least, we bleed green. In fact, I think it's fair to say that Stephanie and I have done our part as good Bearcats to continue to try to brainwash our children, and we have a 2-year-old and a 6-year-old, and it does not matter what football team is playing on TV. Andrew stands there and screams at the TV, "Go Bearcats!" Our six-year-old Addison, now this little girl is a true defender of Northwest. Andrew and Addison go to a school where many of the teachers and the grad assistants are actually students and or graduates of Mo West. And every time that Addison proudly wears her Bearcat shirt or Andrew wears his Bearcat hat, you know, those Mo West folks, they give them a hard time. And being the good Bearcat that I am, I've armed Addison with the absolute defense. That cute little six-year-old just stands up and tells them, hey, those who can, they go to Northwest. Those who can't, they go to Mo West. Back to Mike in my remarks for today. As I was sharing with Mike how excited I was to be here and sharing with him some of the very insightful words that I'd be sharing today, Mike said, hey, let me put your mind at ease. He said, don't worry about it. Don't obsess over it. I said, really? He said, sure. They're never going to remember who you were or what you said. So my goal for today is pretty simple. I'm not so much worried if you remember who I am, but I hope you remember a couple of the things that I have to say. So let's begin. First, I want to congratulate you on reaching this milestone in life. Your persistence, your perseverance, they've paid off. Graduation represents the highest level of commitment an individual can make to their personal dedication towards advancing their future. In accepting the rigors and challenges of obtaining a college education, you've now earned the reputation of a person who is dedicated, who's willing to work hard to achieve their goals. These traits will serve you well, and they will be necessary to be successful in life. Your experiences and academic achievements here are the cornerstone for a strong foundation. So, get ready to learn. It begins now. No matter what opportunities that may be open through the doors that are about to occur, the completion of your degree and your success in the future will only come from the choices you make and your willingness to work hard. Opportunity and success are never given. They are earned. They are earned through hard work. They are earned through determination and dedication, the exact same dedication and determination that has led you here today. Your ability to take advantage of the opportunities before you and achieve success will be dependent on the goals you set for yourself and your willingness to work hard to achieve those goals. So until now, you've had one goal, right? Get through college. Well, congratulations, you've made it. And although you've now accomplished that goal, it remains critical that you as an individual continue to set goals for yourself, both personal goals and professional goals. These can be long-term goals that you may achieve over a few months short-term goals that you may achieve over a few months, or long-term goals that may take years. Years of persistence, years of perseverance. But no matter what goal you set, you must always challenge yourself. Challenge your abilities and commit to a brighter future. Now, these goals, they should never be easy. Because what that means is they will come with challenges. But as you have already experienced from your time here, the best educational lessons often come along the journey, not necessarily at the destination. Life throws us a few curveballs from time to time, and as you navigate these obstacles and challenges, you'll be building on that foundation as you make a life for yourself, your family, your loved ones. There will come a day when you are well on your way of achieving those goals, and that is when, I hope, you're willing to embark on one of the more noble goals in life, the bettering the quality of life for the next generation. So let there be no confusion. I'm an unabashed defender of the private sector. I believe this nation is great in spite of government, not because of it. I believe the greatest innovations are a result of intense competition. Many of the most brilliant minds I've had the opportunity to be around are individuals who are deeply rooted in the private sector, but who understood that we all have a responsibility to take time and give back through public service. This brings me to my fundamental point for today. As a community, as a state, and as a nation, we need private sector leaders who are believers, who understand it is time, you must take time out of your lives to engage in public service. We don't need more career politicians. We need more citizen legislators. We need people who understand that public service is an honor and a sacrifice, and that ultimately, they're going to be returning home to serve under the laws they've created. You know, at the end of the day, as we all get up and we work hard, ultimately, we're going to go home. We're going to go home to our families. We're going to go home to our businesses. But most importantly, when that happens, as we talk about leaders, we need people who who understand that true leadership comes through vision and inspiration, not fear and intimidation. In life, we strive to ensure that tomorrow is brighter because of our actions today. We hope for an environment where possibilities are limitless and potentials run free. Much like our founding fathers, I truly believe we have a duty to serve. We serve our communities and improve the life of the next generation. The successes and opportunities we have been given were made possible because of the determination and the dedication of prior leaders. I want you to take a moment and think. Think about where you would be today if the generations before you had not been willing to give back. I want you to stop and think if our founding fathers had not stood up for freedom and liberty, or the greatest generation had not been willing to fight and work together to support one another during the Great Depression, or those who have paid the ultimate price for our nation had not been willing to take up arms and sacrifice their lives to protect this nation and what we believe in. Where would we be if the brightest among us had not passed along their understanding of the world, or if our greatest statesmen, people like John F. Kennedy and Ronald Reagan, had not entered public office? Where would Northwest be without the commitment of those individuals who have walked these halls before you? Where would you be if your parents, if your teachers, your friends, your community leaders had not taken the time to teach and guide you through these years? We all have a civic responsibility to give back to our communities more than we've taken from them. And this can be done in many ways, whether it's service on local boards, charitable organizations, scout leaders, coaches, mentors, role models, or setting aside your private life to serve our communities in city halls, county courthouses, and state capitals across the country. One of the most important things that you will do is work to having a positive impact on the future. Whether you decide to serve in government, volunteer for organizations, or use your talents to support foundations or other causes, your commitment to our communities are necessary and imperative if future generations are going to have the same opportunities that we've been given. We will always need leaders, dedicated individuals who are willing to accept the baton and run our portion of the race. So today I challenge you. I challenge you to embrace the responsibilities of public service and set goals that will lead us to greater prosperity while providing a better quality of life for the next generation. Clearly, we do not and will not agree on the path, but our ability and willingness to disagree, to persevere, and to ultimately find resolution is what makes this country great. It is what makes our form of government and our way of life different from so many others. Your service should be selfless, and it will be fought with the same pitfalls and obstacles that you find in your private life. You will be challenged in your service, but always remember that the commitment to bettering our way of life has made our communities, our state, and our nation the greatest in the world. We have all heard the saying, from those whom much is given, much is expected. As I look across these graduates, as I look at the great people in this auditorium, we have been given much. We have been given the opportunity to better ourselves, the privilege to attend this institution, and the talents to succeed. Therefore, my friends, it should come as no surprise and with no limit to what is expected of you. So today, as you walk across this stage and receive the recognition and rewards for the many hours and years of hard work, never forget the journey. Never forget what it took to get here, and never forget what it will take to succeed in the future. Be true to yourself. Be thankful. Be grateful for those who have helped you, and make a commitment to challenging your abilities, working tirelessly towards your goals, and giving back to your community. So, for this graduating class, be it resolved that we gather today to acknowledge, to salute, and to congratulate this tremendous accomplishment. I offer you hearty congratulations on a job well done. You've made your friends, your family, your community proud. Enjoy this day and take time to enjoy this achievement. Take time to celebrate. Remember that all the great times you have had here at Northwest, but most importantly, prepare for the exciting opportunities that await you, because truly our future rests in your hands. May God bless the opportunities, the accomplishments, and life's lessons that take place on this campus. And may good blessings and much success reside within these walls, so that those who have and those who still will walk within them will be lifelong learners, community pillars, and tomorrow's leaders. Congratulations. Thank you. God bless you, and good luck. Thanks, John.
Candidates for graduation, as you can tell, Senator Lager is unabashed in his support of Northwest Missouri State University. I guess Andrew and Addison are too, right? Is that right? I'll tell you what, the Lager family certainly has been part of Northwest Missouri State, but as Brad tells you guys, being pillars of your community, being those future leaders is absolutely critical. And Representative Thompson, Senator Lager, are finishing up their terms as representative and senator, but please, let's give them another round of applause for their public service. Thanks, Mike. Candidates for degrees, will you please help me welcome your Student Senate President, Mr. Cody Ewing.
You've heard it, I don't know, a million and a half times this morning, probably all week, but I'm going to say it again. Congratulations to all of you. You're going to hear it a million more times, and it probably will get old eventually, but we're fine for now. You've made it through an exciting chapter in your life, and you're about to leave here and start on another, and you're leaving from a great university, and you're getting a great degree, and it's going to serve you well for the rest of your life. You're moving away, possibly from Missouri, but you're not going to leave the connections and the friendships that you've made over your time here. You're going to take a piece of Northwest with you as you walk out of here, and you will realize the adage, once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat, is truer than you ever could have imagined. And you're a diverse group, ranging from first-generation graduates to returning students taking classes that fill your desires, and many of you have been involved in organizations and filled your time here making great memories. If you think back on everything that has happened over your time here, those moments that shaped you as a person will be the ones that you remember for years to come. Now, whether you're ready or not, you're going to leave here this morning, and the world's going to be waiting for you. You're the future, and everything you do after this point will have a great impact on society. You'll face daunting obstacles and great challenges along the way, but my question to you is one that's been posed to me over and over again during my college career by an advisor and a mentor. What is your goal? You're now a college graduate, and you're looking towards the rest of your life, but what is your goal? What is your dream, and how are you going to achieve it? It's easy to say that your goal is to get a great job, start a family, live a happy life. That's great. That's awesome. Now's the time to think about how you're going to get there. But the real question is, what is your goal for you as a person? Who do you want to be when you grow up? Once you've answered that question, shaping your future will be in your hands, and those obstacles won't be so great. You're going to stumble every now and again, but you have a family to fall back on. You have a family back home, but you also have your Northwest family. Your friends, faculty, staff, everyone you've come in contact with here at Northwest has become part of your extended family, and they will all be here to fall back on. The drive away from Maryville will be tough because this has become your home, but you have an entire life ahead of you, and that is truly exciting. I said it at the beginning, and I think we're all a little bit biased up here, but this is a great university, and you're leaving with an amazing degree. And so on behalf of the Student Senate and the entire student body, I want to wish you congratulations on your achievements, and I want to wish you the best of luck on your futures.
I am now honored to introduce Northwest's Provost and Chief Academic Officer, Dr. Doug Dunham.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's my privilege to recognize those baccalaureate students graduating with honors. Their names appear in your commencement program beside a single, double, or triple asterisk. Students graduating cum laude are wearing white honors cords. They have earned a grade point average of 3.5 to 3.74, and their names appear beside a single asterisk. Students graduating magna cum laude are wearing green honors cords. They have earned a grade point average of 3.75 to 3.94, and their names appear beside a double asterisk. Students wearing gold honors cords have earned a grade point average of 3.95 to 4.0. Their names appear in the program beside a triple asterisk, and they will graduate summa cum laude. Honors program graduates are noted with a plus symbol. Would all the degree candidates graduating with honors please stand, and ladies and gentlemen, join me in applauding these outstanding students. Congratulations. Let me make one more brief comment regarding academic regalia. You will soon see candidates for the master's degree recognized with a collared hood, which is placed over their shoulders in recognition of scholarly achievement. The colors symbolize various academic disciplines. Graduates receiving the education specialist degree wear a light blue cord on their right shoulder and a shield-shaped hood. These show that they have completed a minimum of 64 hours of graduate work in education.
Please welcome the Acting Dean of the Melvin D. and Valerie G. Booth College of Business and Professional Studies, Dr. Gregory Haddock.
Will the candidates for bachelor's degrees from the Melvin D. and Valerie G. Booth College of Business and Professional Studies please rise? President Jasinski, these candidates, upon my recommendation and on the recommendation of the faculty and chairpersons of the Departments of Business, Agricultural Sciences, and Communication and Mass Media, are presented to you for the conferral of bachelor's degrees. Will the candidates please come forward?
Lauren N. Buholt. Cho Cho. Anna Marie Jordaning. Martin Anthony Pasley. Vincent Edward Voss. Brandon Joseph Fangman. Jacob Davis. Alexandra K. Anderson. Anna Marie Hazley. Kylie Marie Cantrell. Andrew A. Babulka Jr. Andrew Wesley Club. Clayton Shelby Allen. Alex Marie Snyder. Jacob Andrew Phipps. Matthew J. Melcher. Michael C. Brown. Wesley Donald Wilson. Brandon Christian Hink. Luke Allen Nissen. Brandy M. Rundy. Jessica Lynn Kiefer. Melanie Faye Barnett. Emily Ann Robinson. Amanda Dawn Clark. Brian Edward Kurtz. Jessica Lynn Murphy. Jane Marie Havel. Emma Julaine Sunderman. David Michael Slater. Alex Newley Bruner. Danielle Nicole Stewart. Justin Craig Hazen. Heidi Lynn Hartzler. Miranda Lauren Dietz. Chase Andrew Baldridge. Michael Allen Harper. Christopher Leviticus Marshall Bowser. Scott Aaron Nelson. Spencer Todd Schultz. Matthew Russell Johnson. Colin Jeffrey Porter. Chance Dallas Parsons. Danielle Nicole Mullins. Catherine A. Marsh. Taylor Robert Grimm. Dominique Dijon Evans. Dylan Scott Black. Philip M. Rocker. Paige Allison Malinowski. Cassie Nicole Ward. Shelby Renee Hunter. Elena Marie Bellano. Jillian Kathleen Smith. Marie Irene Brancato. John Bakari. Ryan David Abernathy. Sam Andrews. John Kaufman. Paul William Johnson. Wesley William Rockwood. Austin Blaine Riley. Tyler James Bielek. Benjamin David Lawson. Caesar Williams III. Katie Lee Nyer. Emily Marie Bowman. Donnie Merriman. Bryce Jacob Marinas. Craig Allen Sims. Edward Lucas Oster. Dalton Jacob Larson. Andrew Michael Clements. Bryce Anthony Searin. Taylor May Dorsey. Nicholas A. Comer. Corey Nels Lauridson. Kyle Lynn Schlake. Martin Ross Tiemann. Jill Erin Boland. Ashley Rochelle Summers. Sydney Lawrence. Adam David Hazelhorst. Jason Dean Miller. Whitney Rachel Rissler. Riley James Mole. Chelsea Faye Asmus. Chance Michael Lambrick. Scott Gregory Tobin. Jessica Lee Vervaki. Ashley Ann McGinnis. Alyssa Ann Lanter. Emily Louise Lingo. Lillian E. Gibbons. Christopher Allen Lurch. Kelsey Ray Bartleson. Allison Marie Mattson. Zachary Jerome Smith. Ariana Alexis Watson. Caitlin Marie Rart. Todd Edgar Swetnam. Louis Lowe. Jacob William Kircher. Logan Andrew Compton. Cameron Matthew Raymakers. Rachel Diane Kendall. Brittany Nicole Ehlers. Haley Nicole Lewin. Natalie Ann Fry. Carolyn Arlene Robinson. Addison Christine Dirks. Matthew John Willis. Taylor Mark Olson. Ronnie Leon Oxier. Dante Arnell Moore. Christy Nicole Nance. Jordan L. Paul. Brittany Nicole McClure. Dylan Matthew Grider. Zachary Ryan Teasley. Reed Ellis Gillespie. Ryan Scott Behrens. Zachary Michael Corbett. Lucas W. Clark. Noah Scott Stahl. Michael Frank Kaufman. Jacob Anthony Scarbo. Jonathan Blake Harsley. Kelly Ann Wharton. Rebecca Lynn Van Cura. Stephen Ray Schwartz. Holly Nicole Hamilton. Ashley Nicole Roberts. Paige Rachelle McGinley. Tykela Morel Gaddy. Gabrielle Alexandria Ray. Jaron Dominique Robinson. Rachel Ann Zumbrunnen. Rachel Lynn Kekareka. Darren James Adams. Devin O'Ken. Andrew Joseph Chore. Ashley Danielle Kendrick. Maggie Jo Rutter. Jordan Douglas Watson. Avery Nicole Reagan. Teely Marie Ray. Tristan Ann Myers. Heidi Stallman. Sarah Elizabeth Hickson. Caitlin Amanda Paulson. Kelsey Christine Schwartz. Courtney Joy Apperson. Katie Marie McDonald. Alyssa Morgan Goose. Derek Ray Bonner. Troy August Dobson. Denham Jeremy Schekinger. Jacob Vincent Trentman. Ethan Robert Bjorn. Jake M. Wendling. Miranda Page Jones. Matthew Charles Fritsch. Michael Thomas Tracy. Daniel David LePerry. Joshua Theodore Gusak. Riley Michael Zimmer. Brandon Thomas Watson. Monique Catherine Stevens. Brianna Elise Forbes. Abby Donovan Schreck. Samantha Paige Nowakowski. Taylor Ashley Runke. Benjamin Thomas Thrum. Megan Elizabeth Caswell. Zachary Taylor Ball. Leslie Rose Feldhaus. Amanda Lynn Lovell. Shelby Nicole Montgomery. Bailey Lynn Smith. Zach Scott Goldsmith. Taylor Renee Hartung. Jennifer Lynn McCoy. Jessica Caroline Kunkel. Michaela Mary Fay Keller. Savannah Lee Cox. Courtney Faye Clemens. Samantha Sunshine Cole. Taylor Marie Neff. Kylie Marie Nischel. Nicole Marie Kunkin. Amanda Marie Sullivan. Laurel Christine Holmquist. Emily A. Chowdhury. Kaylee Louise Shelford. Anissa Christine DeMar. Taylor Catherine Getz. Alexandra Marie Fellum. Jonathan Rivera.
We'll pause just for a moment while our degree candidates finish getting their picture taken and return to their seats. Would the candidates for bachelor's degree please stand? By the authority vested in me by the State of Missouri and our Board of Regents, I confer upon you, subject to completion of all requirements as certified by our registrar, the bachelor's degree, and admit you to the Fellowship of Educated Men and Women with all its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate these new graduates as they move their tassels. Congratulations, Bearcats.
Will the candidates for master's degrees please rise? President Jasinski, these candidates, on my recommendation and on the recommendation of the graduate faculty, the college deans, and the graduate dean, are presented to you for conferral of master's degrees. Will the candidates please come forward? Dr. Gregory Haddock, our Vice Provost and Dean of the Graduate School, will place academic hoods on the shoulders of these graduates.
Shinichi Nagata. Brett Miguez. Corbin L. Kremelmeyer. Erica Leston. Ashley Marie Gove. Erica Lee Clark. Allison Grace Page. Karen Elizabeth Marino. Jacqueline Hunt. Blake Allen Duran. Amanda May Rollitz. Jean Messner Eckert. Jamie Lynn Berry. Andrea Lynette Ryan. Melissa M. Torres. Amanda Grace Bearden. Natalie Darlene Potier. Rebecca Ann Irwin. Jessica Zhang Decker. Lindsay Ann Steele. Valerie Ann Neal. Adrian Christine Palmer. Jocelyn Michelle Stahl. Sunshine Ray Williams. Kelsey Amundson. Gloria K. Gable Warren. Bridget Louise Wells. Jamie Janae Castile. Elizabeth Marie Hagen. Christina Janice Street. Rachel Ann Frazee. Brent Christopher Trout. Christy Rasmussen. Nicholas John Murkowski. James William Miller. Aaron Brayman. Bala Chaitanya Mata. Shinton Reddy Chintala. Sujit Kumar Tumala. Dheeraj Gunda. Garima Dakal. Purnima Bandare. Vitatri Manur. Satish Kumar Buswapuram. Stephanie J. Shaw. Ryan Meyer. Cameron Michael Bedard. Jacob Lee Klingensmith. Ashton Pauline Ellis. Anna Fair Schoonover. Ellie Lorraine Backus. Teal Don Hawker. Hong Gao. Shen Yi Yin. Diana Lynn Stevens. Bharat Kumar Reddy Rupireddy. Praneet Reddy Pulapalli. Rishi Chaudhry Pentiala. Fani Kumar Kodavati. Rohit Krishna Sakamuri. Rakesh Chaudhry Chundi. Bilal Muhammad. Sesenk Alembota. Chaitanya Sega Pedabuti. Mahender Dhanam. Srinivas Kaleru. Sai Sadar Yerabaka. Santosh Kumar Nila. Suram Jani. Jaswan Rao Vura. Pradush Reddy. Grishma Gadi. Nicole Richardson. Laura Lynn Nichols Henke. Aisha Sultana Sheikh. Anusha Panugu. Shivanandana Reddy Aleti. Sandi Kumari Pupuri. Sinduri Mutiala. Divya Sadanehi. Vinila Yedaveli. Abdul Khalik Sheikh. Mohan Bikina. Dushyant Parvaneti. Saiteja Mandalapu. Harika Narendra. Gopala Krishna. Abhinay Reddy Ragi. Venkatesh Padma.
And again, we'll just pause for a moment while our degree candidates finish getting their picture taken. Sure standing. Will the candidates for master's degree please stand? By the authority vested in me by the State of Missouri and our Board of Regents, I confer upon you, subject to completion of all requirements as certified by our registrar, the master's degree, and admit you to the fellowship of educated men and women with all its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate these new graduates as they move their tassels.
congratulations. You could be seated now. And will the candidates for specialist in education degrees please rise? President Jasinski, these candidates, on my recommendation and on the recommendation of the graduate faculty, the college deans, and the graduate dean, are presented to you for conferral of specialist in education degrees. Will the candidates please come forward?
Stephanie Ann Merritt. Robin Michelle Housel.
For our specialist degree candidates, by the authority vested in me by the State of Missouri and our Board of Regents, I confer upon you, subject to completion of all requirements as certified by our registrar, the specialist in education degree, and admit you to the Fellowship of Educated Men and Women with all its rights, honors, privileges, and obligations. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate these new graduates. All right, sign up. Graduates, I don't say candidates for a degree, I say graduates. Congratulations. You've been Bearcats, but now you are alumni, and we welcome you to the alumni family, the Alumni Association. Here to do that is Joan Jackson. She graduated from Northwest Missouri State University, and she's a proud graduate of the 1965 class. She is an active member of our Southern Iowa chapter of the Northwest Alumni Association. Let's give a big, big Bearcat welcome to Joan as she brings you greetings.
B-E-A-R-C-A-T-S, Bearcats, Bearcats, go Bearcats! Woo! Good morning. Northwest grads, it is my pleasure to congratulate and welcome you into the Northwest Alumni Association, a group of more than 70,000 members, all with the same distinction of calling Northwest Missouri State University our alma mater. I would like to take this few minutes to recognize the Northwest alumni in the audience today. Please stand and show your Bearcat spirit. Come on, alumni. My My name is Joan Jackson, and I too am a proud Northwest alum and honored to speak to you on behalf of the Northwest Alumni Board of Directors. You have received a quality education, gained valuable experience, and created lasting relationships. Each of you, no doubt, is looking forward to new careers in new places. As your alumni association, we ask you to stay in touch with us by getting involved at one of the 19 alumni chapters across the country and in Japan. You can find a listing of those chapters in your commencement program. Once again, congratulations, and remember that wherever you go and whatever you do, Northwest Alumni Association will be here to help you connect with your Northwest family. And always remember, once a Bearcat, always a Bearcat. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joan, I think, typifies what it means to stay connected. And you heard Senator Lager challenge you to be leaders, but especially provide that service and stay connected within your communities. We ask you to stay connected to Northwest. Senator Lager, you also talked about persistence, and you know what? I'm going to stay persistent and say, let's try to watch that video before we close. Is that okay? I'm taking a chance here. I'm rolling the dice. So if you can sit back, we'll take a look at the video.
It means support, it means acceptance.
People are friendly, and you learn the real American culture.
I think Northwest is a very intimate university. I was able to have like a great relationship with my advisor.
It's just very welcoming and warming and very close-knit and just a really positive community.
The business department, professors, have been like my guardian angels. I can go to them for practically anything.
They want you to grow, and they expect you to grow, and I love that.
They're, you know, looking out for our best interests and definitely try to help us in our time of needs, and you know, that's even something outside of the academic classroom, just being almost like a friend.
Northwest gives me the opportunity in my classes to experience real life scenarios. Enough marketing research, we had to actually go out and help a client.
I feel like Northwest has made me have to grow up a little bit faster than I would have somewhere else. Coming in, I was able to get started with the Missourian staff right away.
I love everything about Northwest. Everyone from people that work here to the students. I love the campus. I love the atmosphere there is around sports.
My favorite trimester is always the fall trimester. Homecoming, walkout day, just the different traditions.
The campus is really beautiful during the daytime, but at night, when you're just walking home or walking back to your dorm, walking to the library, this is gonna sound cheesy, but it's kind of magical.
My dad was the only one that went to college back home, so, you know, my sister never finished, so it's kind of important that I did it.
I am a first-time college graduate for my family, and it's a really proud accomplishment because I'm able to bring home a degree. I'm able to get a really good job.
I mean, I couldn't be more grateful. I'm glad that I chose this university because Northwest really, really does provide every possible opportunity for you.
I love the people at Northwest.
Like, it just feels right. Like, I just feel like this is where I need to be.
I'm away from home, but the Northwest really is the second home.
Thanks to those that contributed those reflections, but I know each of you can reflect back fondly on your time at Northwest. We congratulate you. We want you to have a great afternoon, great day today. But again, stay connected in your travels throughout your lifetime. Please allow me to take a moment to thank our color guard, our musicians. Thank you very much. Faculty marshals, our honor marshal. Thank you. I'm going to keep going, though. Our banner carriers, our MC, Amanda Pettifish-Schrog. Amanda, thank you so much for all that you do. Our commencement coordinator, Gina Bradley. Thanks to all of you for your participation in making this a special ceremony. Graduates, you have turned your tassels and received your diplomas. You are now proud Northwest alumni. Members of the Green and White family, you heard one of over 70,000 proud alumni. You are part of a cherished and unbelievably supportive Bearcat network that celebrates Northwest's long tradition of excellence. Use that network, ladies and gentlemen. Use your network of Bearcats out there. Stay in touch. Let us know how you're doing. Reach out to fellow Bearcats. Stay connected. Your diploma is testament to your decision to live and work as an educated person. Our society needs you now more than ever. On behalf of my wife, Denise, along with all of us at Northwest, let me say how proud we are of you as Bearcats. Again, I thank Senator Lager for your remarks and your service, Mike Thompson for your service as well. Go forth, make Northwest proud as you contribute to the societal good. Go lead the Bearcat way. Congratulations.
Graduates, please return your gown within 45 minutes to Martindale Hall, room 101, following the recessional. You will be greeted there by members of the Northwest Alumni Association and given a memento of new membership. Guests, please allow the platform party, faculty, and graduates to recess and then follow. Congratulations to our graduates, and thank you, guests, for your attendance this morning. Please join in singing the Northwest Alma Mater.